Hello friends, today we are going to see midpoint circle algorithm. Okay, we have already seen Bresenham circle algorithm. So the algorithm of midpoint circle drawing goes almost on the similar lines with the Bresenham circle algorithm. And it further modifies the algorithm of Bresenham's and slightly reduces the calculation. And the fact that the circular symmetry which we saw in the Bresenham circle algorithm, that is been retained, and we only try to generate the circular curve in one of the octants, as we have 8 octants. We have divided the circle into 8 octants, so we only try to generate the circular curve or circular arc in one of the octants, and then using the symmetry of all the remaining octants, we just copy the curvature into the remaining 7 octants. So we will see a procedure to generate a circular arc in the first quadrant's octant, starting from x equal to 0, y equal to r, that is 90 degrees, and moving in the clockwise direction towards x equal to y point, that is a 45 degree line in the first quadrant. So that first octant we will try to generate the circular arc, and then using the symmetry of the octants, we will copy this into the remaining 7 octants. So let's get started. For a given radius r and screen center position x comma y, we can first set up our algorithm to calculate pixel positions around a circle path centered at the coordinate origin. So coordinate origin that we are going to select as the circle's center, and the arc will be circle will be created around the center of the coordinate origin. So then the each calculated pixel position, that is x comma y, is moved to its proper screen position by adding x to x and y to y. So the decision that we need to make while we are creating a circular arc in the first octant is whether to decrement y or not to decrement y. As similarly we had also made a similar decision in Bresenham circle algorithm, so here also we will be making a similar decision whether to decrement y or not to decrement y. And with x, since it is in the first octant, it is always going to be incremented. It is always going to be incremented. So along the circle section from x equal to 0 to x equal to y, that is the first in the first quadrant, we call this section of circle as first octant. So in first quadrant we have two octants, from 90 to 45, 45 to 0. 45 to 0 is the second octant. So we will be creating the circular arc in the first octant, starting from x equal to 0 to x equal to y. And the slope of the curve varies from 0 to minus 1. So if we find the slope of the curve, what do we mean by slope of the curve? Slope of the curve is the tangent drawn at a specific point to that particular curve. And slope of that tangent is basically slope of the curve. So as you can see, the tangent that is drawn at x equal to y will have slope equal to minus 1, and tangent drawn at x equal to 0, that is the exact vertical line. So if I draw a tangent to that vertical line, it will be a horizontal line, and horizontal line has slope equal to 0. So that is the reason why they are saying slope varies from 0 to minus 1. So we can take unit steps in the positive x direction over this octant and use a decision parameter to determine which of the two possible y positions are closer to the circle path at each step. So whether the y position is closer which doesn't require decrement of y, or y position is closer which requires decrement of y, that we are going to identify. And positions in the other 7 octants are then obtained by symmetry. So that's what I just said. To apply the midpoint method, we use this circle equation, So this is a circle equation with its center exactly at origin. Okay, so we don't have any intercepts, okay, because the center lies at origin. So the equation of circle goes like x square plus y square minus r square. Okay, in other words, it is x square plus y square equal to r square. So we have taken everything on one side and written that as equation of circle or function of circle. Okay, at any point x comma y on the boundary of the circle. Now with this kind of a explanation for circle equation, okay, we get a very nice property. Okay, if this function, okay, if this function produces value equal to 0, that means we are exactly on the circumference of circle. If this function, okay, produces a value which is less than 0, okay, which is less than 0, then we are inside the circle. And if this function value produces a value which is greater than 0, then we are outside the circle. Okay, we are outside the circle. So that's what is written over here. If the point is in the interior of the circle function is negative. And if the point is outside the circle function is positive. This is what explained over here. Okay, if circle of xy less than 0, okay, it is inside the circle boundary. Okay, if it is xy equal to 0, it is on the circle boundary. Okay, and if it is greater than 0, it is outside the circle boundary. So as you can see, this is a circle boundary. Okay, this is the x equal to 0, that is y axis, and this is y equal to 0, that is x axis. Okay, or we yet don't know what is x axis basically. Okay, so x axis may be further down. So we are starting from the top pixel. Okay, we are starting from the top pixel. Okay, so xk comma yk is already marked, so this is a starting pixel. Okay, xk comma yk, what we said, since this is the x equal to 0 and this is the y equal to r row, okay, and this is x equal to 0 column, you can say, for the pixel or the grid generations. Okay, then xk comma yk basically will be having coordinates 0 comma r, 0 comma r. So that's what we are doing here. So that is 0 comma r. So this pixel has been marked. Okay, then I have a decision to make whether to mark this pixel or to mark this pixel. Okay, this pixel or this pixel. So if I am going to mark this pixel, okay, automatically my xk is going to be incremented by 1. So it will become xk plus 1. Okay, and if I am going to mark this pixel, my yk is not changing. My yk is remaining to be yk. So that is what the decision that we are going to make depending on the equation of circle. Okay, depending on the equation of circle, which is x square plus y square minus r square equal to 0. So at every location, okay, at every location we will identify what is the value, okay, with this equation. So I have x, y, I will every time change the x and y points. So here the x and y are xk and yk. Here perhaps I will find xk plus 1 comma yk and xk plus 1 comma yk minus 1, and then identify the sign of this function, and depending on the sign I will select the appropriate pixel. Okay, I will select the appropriate pixel. I will select the appropriate pixel. So figure shows the midpoint location. Figure shows the midpoint between the two candidate pixel at sampling position xk plus 1. Okay, so this is the midpoint of the two pixels. So this pixel and this pixel. Okay, this pixel and this pixel. This is the midpoint. So assuming we have just plotted the pixel at xk comma yk, we need to determine whether the pixel at position xk plus 1 comma yk or the one at position xk plus 1 comma yk minus 1 is closer to the circle. Okay, so how we identify that? We identify that based on a decision parameter. Okay, decision parameter, which is directly calculated from the equation of circle. So this function of circle or equation of circle eventually gives us our decision parameter variable. Okay, and based on the value of the decision parameter, or basically based on the sign of the decision parameter, we are going to select the appropriate pixel position. So if my pk, okay, which eventually is the function of circle at that particular pixel location, okay, is less than 0, this midpoint is inside the circle and the pixel on scan line yk is closer to the circle boundary. So as you can see, this midpoint, okay, is inside this circle, and in that case I am going to select this upper pixel, that is xk plus 1 comma yk. That means I am not going to decrement y. Otherwise the midpoint position is outside or on the circle boundary, and we select the pixel on scan line yk minus 1. So the remaining case is what? That can be on the circle boundary or it can be outside the circle boundary. So in those cases, okay, as you can see over here, perhaps, okay, again the midpoint would, see this particular case, again the midpoint would be outside the second case that I am talking about, xk plus 2 and yk or yk minus 1. So this midpoint will lie outside, and that is the reason why we will select the we will decrement the y coordinate to yk minus 1. So that is how it goes, and same has been explained over here. So it is xk plus 1 comma yk minus half. Okay, so if I find out, if I simplify this, xk plus 1 the whole square plus yk minus half the whole square minus r square, okay, I can do further calculation and find out the successive decision parameter values, okay, and we obtain a recursive expression for the next decision parameter by evaluating the circle function at sampling points, that is xk plus 1 plus 1, that becomes eventually xk plus 2, okay, and I find the next decision parameter as pk plus 1, that is pk plus 2 xk plus 1 plus yk plus 1 the whole square minus yk square minus yk plus 1 minus yk plus 1. Okay, where yk is either yk or yk minus 1 depending on the sign of pk. Okay, the initial decision parameter is obtained by evaluating the circle function at the start position, that is x0 comma y0, which is the starting position 0 comma r. Okay, 0 comma r. It is calculated as phi by 4 minus r. Okay, when we put the coordinates as x equal to 0, y equal to r in the circle equation and simplify, we get this equation. P0 equal to phi by 4 minus r. Okay, now phi by 4 has no basically significance, since we have already said we will be eliminating all those if possible, okay, we will be eliminating all those calculation which involves division operation. Okay, now in circle still it is possible to eliminate division operation. So instead of writing phi by 4 minus r, okay, if the radius r is specified as an integer, we can simply round P0 to 1 minus r for r as an integer. Okay, if r is not integer, then perhaps we will keep it as phi by 4 minus r. Okay. So having said that, let us look at the algorithm steps. So input radius r and circle center xc comma yc and obtain the first point on the circumference of circle centered on the origin as x0 comma y0 equal to 0 comma r. Then calculate the initial value of the decision parameter as phi by 4 minus r. Okay, that we have just said, if r is going to be integer, it will be only 1 minus r. So we will be using only 1 minus r, and this algorithm is going to be used for fraction radius also. Okay, so if we modify p0 to phi by 4 minus r, okay, it adds up that division operation. Okay, but then it can be applied to the radius having decimal numbers, so let's say 10.5 or 11.5. okay, all those kind of radius will be able to plot on the graphical screen, graphical output screen. Okay, so at each xk position starting at k equal to 0, perform the following test. If pk is less than 0, the next pixel along the circle centered on 0 comma 0 is xk plus 1 comma yk. That means we are not going to decrement yk. And the next decision parameter is given as pk plus 1 is pk plus 2 xk plus 1 plus 1. Okay. Otherwise, the next point along the circle is xk plus 1 comma yk minus 1. So that is the else part. That is, either it is equal to 0 or greater than 0. Okay, and the next decision parameter is given by pk plus 1 equal to pk plus 2 xk plus 1 plus 1 minus 2 yk plus 1, where 2 xk plus 1 is 2 xk plus 2 and 2 yk plus 1 is given as 2 yk minus 2. Okay, so just not to get confused with those subscript increments. Okay, they just mean that, okay, whatever current position we are having, okay, in the successive iterations, plus one will be added in the x coordinate, and depending on the sign of pk, okay, y will not be changed or y will be decremented by 1. So if it is going to successively decrement by 1, so it will become 2yk minus 1, then yk minus 2, yk minus 3, and so on. Then we determine the symmetry points in the other 7 octants using the same functionality. Okay, what we did last time was we executed the function that many number of times by changing the signs of x and y as it was explained in the octant generation method. Okay, and then move each calculated pixel position x comma y onto the circular path centered on xc comma yc and plot the coordinate values. So x equal to x plus xc and y equal to y plus yc. So that's what we do while we are copying the first curvature that is generated in the first octant into the remaining 7 octants, and repeat steps 3 through 5 until x greater than equal to y. So this we are going to do till we get x equal to y and or x greater than equal to y, depends. Okay, a greater than sign has been kept because not all the time we will reach x equal to y point. Okay, so for radius 10 we are reaching x equal to y point, but for some other radius we may not reach x equal to y point. So we are including the x greater than y condition as well. So that is the algorithm. Now let us look at the same example, x equal to 0, y equal to r. So we are going to generate the pixels for the radius r and centered at x equal to 0, y equal to 0. So centered at coordinate origin with radius r. So we identify first decision parameter as 1 minus r, that is minus 9. Okay, so I have a table k, pk, then the xk plus 1 comma yk plus 1, that is the next pixel position, then 2xk plus 1, 2yk plus 1. Okay, so for this first circle centered on coordinate origin, the initial point is 0 comma 10, so that is the initial point. And initial increment terms for calculating the decision parameters are 2x0 is 0 and 2y0 is 20. So x0 is 0, y0 is 20. Successive decision parameter values and positions along the circle path are calculated like this. So the first decision parameter for k equal to 0 happens to be negative, less than 0. So I am going to only increment x and not to decrement y. So y I have not decremented, as you can see over here. Okay, then again I find the next decision parameter as minus 9 plus 2xk plus 1. So now current xk plus 1 is 1, so it is 2 plus 1, that is 3. So minus 9 plus 3 becomes minus 6. Okay, again it is less than 0, so I will only increment x and not decrement y, so it is still 2 comma 10. Okay, then again I will find this third decision parameter, that is minus 6 plus 4 plus 1, that is 5. So minus 6 plus 5, that is minus 1. Okay, again it is less than 0, so I will only increment x, not decrement y. Okay, again I will go and find out the next decision parameter. So now here it is 3, so 3 plus 2, 6 plus 1, 7, and it is minus 1, so 7 minus 1, 6. So now it became positive. Okay, so I will also decrement y. So now incremented x and decremented y, so 4 comma 9. Okay, now since it is positive, so I will be referring this decision parameter. So it is going to be 6 plus 2 into 4 plus 1, that is 9, minus 2 into 9, so that is 9 minus 18, that is minus 9, and pk that we got was 6. So 6 minus 9, that is minus 3. Okay, minus 3. So I again got it negative. So I will be only incrementing x and not decrementing y. So if I continue further the calculation, the successive iterations, okay, I eventually reach to a point which is 7, 7. So this is the first point. This is second point 1, 10. This is third point 2, 10. This is fourth point 3, 10. Then 4, 9, 5, 9. Then 6, 8, and eventually I end up in this 7, 7. So if I further continue in this algorithm, okay, the loop that I'm going to make, okay, will become invalid since x will become greater than y. So I have to stop at this point only, and then I will be only mirroring whatever I have got through these octant lines. So this is a 45 degree octant line in the first quadrant. So I'll be mirroring it the way it looks. Okay, so this point will stay, this will come here, these two will go in the vertical direction, and these horizontals will go into the vertical direction. So that is what we are going to be doing in the while copying these pixel positions in the remaining 7 octants. Okay, quickly have a look at the program. So I have integer x 0, y equal to radius, and initial decision parameter as 1 minus radius. Okay, and I'm going to plot the first point. Okay, so first point will be plotted at that we will see during the program. Just we'll try to see the logic. The program slightly has been modified. So while x less than y, x plus plus. Okay, if p less than 0, I'm going to use this decision parameter, else I'm going to decrement y and use this decision parameter, and every time it calculates x and y, I'm going to plot the point. Okay, I'm going to plot the point, and this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, okay, are for plotting the points in the all remaining octants. Okay, so I hope this was of some use. Okay, next up we will see the Turbo C program for the same. Okay, so this is the midpoint circle program. Okay, I have usually the include files I have written. So graphics.h I have included, stdio.h standard input output, connection input output, conio.h and math.h. Okay, now what I have done over here, tried to keep the void main exactly same as during the Bresenham circle algorithm time. So that will make the job easy to write the program. So I have the void pixel function for function declaration. I'll just write here for copying curvature in all octants. Okay. Then I have void main, so I have graphic variable declaration, that is int gd equal to detect comma gm. Then I have the xc yc, that is for the center coordinate, then r for the radius, x comma y for the pixel positions, and p for the decision variable. Then I am going to use the graphical initialization function, init graph ampersand gd ampersand gm, and then the physical address of the graphical drivers for this Turbo C package, that is C:\ Turbo C3/BGI. Okay, that is the physical address where the graphical drivers are stored. Then center coordinate and radius will be entered by user. So I am making the output statement, enter the coordinates of the center of circle, storing it in xc comma yc, and enter the radius of circle. Okay, I am keeping it right now the integer radius. So even if the user enters the float value, okay, in this particular program the float value will not be considered. So I am keeping it as percent d only and taking it inside the variable r. Then I am making the calculations, x equal to 0, y equal to r. Okay, x equal to 0, y equal to r, and my first decision parameter for integer radius, okay, first decision parameter, okay, this is for integer radius, is going to be 1 minus r. okay, 1 minus r, and then I'm calling the function, that is pixel xcyc x comma y. So it will go inside the function and plot the first pixel point. Okay, so the function is very simple over here. As you can see, pixel integer xc, integer yc, integer x, integer y. What it does, xc plus x, yc plus y, okay, it plots the point. The put pixel is going to put the pixel or print the pixel at the given specified coordinate location. Similarly, it will do this in all 8 octants. Okay, this is the first octant, this is the second octant, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth. Okay, so simultaneously, whatever pixel positions we get over here, okay, will be simultaneously printed in all the, or plotted in all the 8 octants at the same time. Okay, then we come here, while x less than y. Okay, this is the loop for plotting all the points. Okay, I should not say, yeah, all the remaining points, correct, all the remaining points in all the octants. While x less than y, what I am going to do, every time it enters inside the loop, I am going to increment x. Okay, every time it enters inside the loop, I am going to increment the x. So x plus plus, I will check the sign of p, that is the decision parameter. So I have already calculated first decision parameter over here, that is p equal to 1 minus r. I will check its sign. If it is less than 0, I will go here and calculate the next decision parameter as p equal to p plus 2 into x plus 1. Okay, else it is going to be y decremented. Okay, y will be decremented, and the next decision parameter will be calculated as p plus 2 into bracket x minus y plus 1. Okay, and then I am again going to make a function call. So once I decide whether this, based on the sign of decision parameter, okay, what exactly I have to do, so whether if the sign is negative, then I am going to only increment x and not to decrement y. If the sign is positive, then I will always be incrementing x, then I will also decrement y. Okay, so, and then the function will be called again, and it will again come inside this function, plot the points in all 8 octants, and again continue calculating the further pixel locations. Okay, once it comes out of the loop, when it will come out of the loop, okay, when it reaches the exact 45 degree mark. So in our case, it reaches the x equal to y, that is 7 equal to 7. Okay, x equal to 7, y equal to 7. Okay, at that time it will stop. Okay, at that time it will stop, because the algorithm says while x less than y. Okay, while x less than y. So then I have getch command to connect input output screens, and then I am closing the graph, okay, to release the graphical memory, and that is the end of the program. So let us now just try to compile the program and check whether there are any errors. Yeah, there are no errors. So then I will execute the program. So I will give, let's say, 200, 200 as the center coordinates. Okay, and radius of the circle I will give as 80. Okay, the circle was created. The circle was created similar to the Bresenham circle program. So I hope this was understood. Okay, the apart from the logic of creating or of selecting the particular pixel, okay, Bresenham and midpoint circle algorithms more or less are on the similar lines. I would say midpoint circle algorithm slightly faster, because it has comparatively less calculation and a very solid logic for selecting a circle based on the equation of circle passing through or equation of circle centered at origin. Okay, centered at origin. So we are using that x square plus y square equal to r square equation. Okay, and that is very convenient to use and very simple to understand. So I hope this was understood. Stay tuned for more such video lectures on computer graphics. Thank you very much.